Welcome back to Mission to Mars. In this video, we will determine the flight of a spacecraft to enter Mars's orbit. Through the Hohmann transfer, we calculated the elliptic trajectory of a flight from Earth to Mars, as well as the initial speed V1 of Earth's departure and final speed V2 of arrival at Mars. These speeds are based on the flight under the influence of the Sun, hence outside the spheres of influence of Earth and Mars. We will now determine the necessary flight conditions for the spacecraft to decelerate from V2 to a circular parking orbit around Mars. To this end, we will use the energy equation and equation and geometry of hyperbolic trajectories. As shown in a previous video, the expressions for such hyperbolic trajectories are given by the following expressions. R equals Rp times 1 plus e over 1 plus e times cosine of theta, and e equals Vp squared over Gm over Rp minus 1. In these expressions, E corresponds to the eccentricity and it exceeds 1, whereas Gm is the gravitational parameter of the planet around which a spacecraft would execute a hyperbolic orbit. When the spacecraft leaves the planet's orbit, the distance r between the centers of mass of the planet and the spacecraft will grow unboundedly. This occurs when the denominator in the first expression in result 1 approaches 0. As a result, 1 plus e times the cosine of theta infinity will equal 0. In this result, theta infinity is the angle under which the spacecraft has reached an infinitely large distance from the center of mass of the planet. According to the geometry of this hyperbolic trajectory, we find that cosine of theta infinity equals cosine of pi minus beta. That equals negative cosine beta. Therefore, for a given Vp and Rp, the eccentricity E and angle beta are directly determined. We will now apply these results to the flight of a spacecraft as it approaches Mars and eventually will be captured into Mars's orbit. From the Hohmann calculations, V2 is the speed relative to the Sun of the spacecraft upon arrival at the edge of Mars's sphere of influence. Let's determine the flight conditions that will allow the spacecraft to be captured into Mars's orbit from this V2. The first step is to calculate the reference velocity V circ m of the spacecraft relative to Mars in the desired circular orbit of given radius Rp around Mars. This is obtained as V squared circ m equals Gmm over Rp, in which Gmm is Mars's gravitational parameter. The next step is to calculate the arrival velocity V2m of the spacecraft with respect to Mars. Since by the Hohmann formulation, V2 is less than Vm, where Vm is the velocity of Mars, this arrival speed, V2m, is obtained as V2m equals Vm minus V2. This is the arrival speed of the spacecraft relative to Mars at a sizably large distance from the center of the red planet. We denote this relative arrival velocity with V infinity m. This is taken as a lower limit to the velocity at the edge of Mars's sphere of influence in the flight towards Mars. The reference radius Rm_SOI of Mars's sphere of influence is calculated as Rm_SOI equals Rm_SMA times GMM over GMS to the power 2/5, where Rm_SMA equals 227,956,000 kilometers, and that is the semi-major axis of Mars's orbit around the Sun. Also, GMM and GMS respectively denote the gravitational parameters of Mars and the Sun. Thus, we find that Rm_SOI equals 577,270 kilometers, or 394.89 times smaller than the average distance between the centers of Mars and the Sun. The arrival speed Vrm of the spacecraft at the desired circular orbit is connected to V infinity m through the energy equation, and this is V squared Rm minus 2gmm over Rp equals V infinity m squared. The eccentricity E is then obtained as E equals V squared arrival m over gmm over Rp minus 1. Hence, the cosine of beta equals 1 over E, and gamma equals 90 degrees minus beta. Let's calculate the numerical values of these quantities for the Hohmann transfer case of V2 that equals 21.4798 kilometers per second, and an RP that equals the radius of Mars plus the height of the spacecraft in orbit around Mars. That gives us 3,389.92 kilometers for the radius of Mars plus 220 kilometers for the height of the spacecraft. The total is 3,609.92 kilometers. Also, the gravitational parameter of Mars, GMM, equals 4.2828 etc. times 10 to the power 4 kilometers cubed per second squared. So we find that V circ M equals 3.44 etc. kilometers per second, omega circ M equals 0.000954 etc. radians per second, V2m, that equals V infinity m, equals 2.6488 kilometers per second, and V arrival at Mars equals 5.544 etc. kilometers per second, omega arrival at Mars equals 0.00153 etc. radians per second, beta equals 51.07 degrees, and gamma equals 38.93 degrees. We observe that V arrival at Mars is greater than V circular at Mars. Therefore, at the appropriate location on the desired circular orbit, the spacecraft must ignite its engine to decrease its speed from V arrival Mars to V circular Mars. The appropriate location when the engines are ignited corresponds to the position vector Rp, making an angle gamma of 38.93 degrees above the line connecting the centers of Mars and the Sun. Let's call this location the reference location. With a V circular M speed, the spacecraft will be captured into Mars's orbit. In the voyage home, the orbiting spacecraft will have to increase its orbital speed to enter a hyperbolic trajectory, reach a Hohmann transfer trajectory, and return to Earth. If the spacecraft does not slow down at the reference location, it will escape Mars's orbit, exit Mars's sphere of influence, and return to a flight that is dominated by the force of gravity of the Sun. Indeed, we will show that the flight of a spacecraft from the reference location with omega equals omega arrival at Mars of 0,00153 etc. radians per second will leave Mars's orbit and reach again the edge of Mars's sphere of influence. At that edge, the flight conditions of the spacecraft will be the following ones. R from Mars equals RM underscore SOI. VR from Mars equals VRM underscore SOI, which is greater than zero. Theta from Mars equals theta m underscore SOI. Omega from Mars equals omega m underscore SOI, which is approximately equal to zero. In these expressions, the subscript from Mars, from m, signifies a flight away from Mars. Since the total energy and total angular momentum of the spacecraft are conserved, the flight away from the reference location is mirror symmetric of the flight from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence to the reference location. Hence, to calculate the flight from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence to the reference location, it suffices to start the calculations from initial conditions that are symmetric to the ones given above. These symmetric conditions are the following ones. R2M, R2 Mars, equals RM underscore SOI. VR2 Mars, VR2M, equals negative VRM underscore SOI. Theta to Mars, theta to M, equals gamma minus theta M underscore SOI minus gamma. That equals 2 gamma minus theta M underscore SOI. And finally, omega to Mars, omega to M, equals omega M underscore SOI. We will now compute the flight within Mars's sphere of influence. To accomplish that, we will calculate the spacecraft flight from the reference position to the edge of Mars's sphere of influence. This will provide the needed information to calculate the symmetric flight from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence to the reference position, which is the approach flight to Mars from Earth. Based on calculations presented in other videos in this course, we will compute the flight of the spacecraft within Mars's sphere of influence through the use of non-dimensional quantities. These are obtained from the connections between dimensional and non-dimensional quantities, as presented before. And these are that time t equals reference time capital T, dimensional, times t tilde, which is non-dimensional. R, dimensional, equals capital R times R, non-dimensional, R tilde. Vr equals capital R over capital T times Vr tilde. Theta is the same as theta tilde. Omega equals 1 over capital T times omega tilde. And Gm tilde equals capital T squared over capital R cubed times the dimensional Gm. The tilde continues to denote non-dimensional variables. GM tilde can be made much smaller than the dimensional GM through a careful selection of the reference time capital T and reference length capital R, so that the ratio capital T squared over capital R cubed becomes much smaller than 1. The reference length capital R is set equal to the initial condition for the dimensional R of the initial flight away from Earth. In that case, capital R was equal to 6,782.94 kilometers. And so, R tilde, the non-dimensional R at the reference location P, equals RP dimensional over the reference length capital R. That provides with the result of 0,5322 etc. units, which is so much smaller than the dimensional RP. The corresponding non-dimensional radius of Mars's sphere of influence is then calculated as RM underscore SOI tilde equals dimensional RM underscore SOI over the reference length capital R. That equals 85,105. Hence, when the computed R tilde reaches this magnitude, the spacecraft will have reached the edge of Mars's sphere of influence. The corresponding dimensional time is found to be 2,431 Earth days. That equals 210,000 seconds. Next, consider the reference time, capital T, expressed as the ratio of two times. Capital T equals T over T tilde, which equals delta T dimensional over delta T tilde. As we have seen, the non-dimensional time, delta T tilde, is the time interval that is used in computations. So, based on computational accuracy consideration, this interval, delta T tilde, is set equal to a small number less than 1. For instance, delta T tilde equals 0,0005. The dimensional time, delta T, equals a fraction of the time needed by the spacecraft for the journey to or from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence with respect to the reference location. As noted before, the time for this journey equals 2,431 Earth days, that is 210,000 seconds. For an extremely accurate calculation, we may choose to set delta T dimensional equal to 1 second. Correspondingly, the reference time, capital T, that equals the ratio delta T dimensional over delta T tilde equals 2,000 seconds, or 105 times smaller than the journey time from the edge of the sphere influence to the reference location. Now, with R that equals 6,782.95 etc. kilometers, and a reference time capital T of 2,000 seconds, the expression for the non-dimensional GM tilde for Mars yields GM tilde equals capital T squared over capital R cubed times the dimensional GM, that equals 0,58939 etc. units. That is significantly smaller than the dimensional GM for Mars, which equals 4,2828 etc. times 10 to the power 4 kilometers cubed over seconds squared. Based on these results, the non-dimensional initial conditions at the reference location become RP tilde equals 0,5322 etc. units, VR tilde equals 0 units, theta tilde equals 0,679 etc. units, omega tilde arrival m equals 3,07197 etc. units. The non-dimensional computations are then carried out with the non-dimensional time step delta t tilde that equals 0,0005, which will generate nearly 210,000 data points for each complete flight to and from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence with respect to the reference location. Once the spacecraft from Earth reaches the reference location, the spacecraft engine is ignited to slow down the spacecraft so that the spacecraft will be captured into a circular orbit around Mars. We will now use the orbital motion Python program that comes with this course to calculate the spacecraft flight to and from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence. The non-dimensional magnitude of gm is entered in the parameters function. The conditions presented above as conditions 2 are then entered as initial conditions in the initconf function. The program may then be run with an initial non-dimensional time of 0 and a final non-dimensional time of, say, 105, and a computational time step of delta t tilde that equals 0,0005. The program generates a solution and stores it in an external file named solution.txt, which may then be post-processed using Excel. We open the solution.txt file in Excel to visualize the solution. We obtain the flight trajectory of the spacecraft towards the edge of Mars's sphere of influence and, as expected, the trajectory is hyperbolic and it approaches an asymptote. The non-dimensional configuration at the edge of Mars's sphere of influence is in the last row of the solution.txt file. It is equal to r tilde from Mars equals r tilde m underscore soi, which equals 85,433 etc. units. Vr tilde from Mars, from m, equals Vr tilde m underscore soi, which equals 0,789 etc. units. Theta tilde from Mars, from m, equals theta tilde m underscore soi, which equals 2,9167 etc. units. Omega tilde from Mars, from m, equals omega tilde m underscore soi, which equals 0,0001 92 etc. units. The corresponding configuration at the symmetric edge of Mars's sphere of influence on the flight from Earth to Mars is then obtained as follows. R tilde to Mars, to m, equals R tilde m underscore soi, which equals 85,433 etc. units. V tilde R to m, Mars, equals negative V tilde R m underscore soi, which equals negative 0,789 etc. units. Theta tilde to Mars, to m, equals, as we saw before, 2 gamma tilde minus theta tilde m underscore soi, which happens to be equal to negative 1,5578 etc. units. Omega tilde to Mars, to m, equals omega tilde m underscore soi, which equals 0,0001119 etc. units. These new initial conditions are then entered in the initConf function in the Python program. The program is then run again with an initial non-dimensional time of 0, a final time of 105, and a computational time step of delta t tilde, which equals 0,0005. The program will generate a new solution and will store it in the usual solution.txt external file. We will open again the solution.txt file in Excel to visualize this solution. We obtain the flight trajectory of the spacecraft, this time towards Mars. As expected, the trajectory is hyperbolic from a vertical asymptote towards the reference location above the red planet. Running the program again with the same initial conditions, initial time and time step, but with twice the final time, generates a solution from edge to edge of Mars's sphere of influence. What this shows is that without deceleration, the spacecraft from Earth approaches but then leaves Mars. The force of gravity of Mars, however, rotates the spacecraft trajectory by an angle that equals exactly to 2 beta. Significantly, this is accomplished without igniting the engine, therefore without consumption of precious limited energy. Such maneuvers are common in spaceflight, and they are called gravity-assisted maneuvers. Running the program one more time with the same non-dimensional initial conditions, non-dimensional initial time, final time, time step, and final time of 105 units generates a trajectory from the edge of Mars's sphere of influence towards Mars all the way to the reference location above the red planet. The non-dimensional configuration at this location is in the last row of the solution.txt file. It is found to be rp tilde equals 0,5322 etc. units, vr tilde equals, approximately 0, theta tilde equals 0,679 etc. units, and omega tilde equals 3,0719 etc. units. It is at this location that the spacecraft engine would be ignited to reduce the angular speed omega tilde to the magnitude corresponding to a circular orbit around Mars. This magnitude equals omega tilde equals 1,908 etc. units. Running the program one last time with the following non-dimensional initial conditions of r tilde at location p equals 0,5322 etc. units, vr tilde of, 0, theta tilde of 0,6794 etc. units, and the new omega of 1,9083 etc. units will generate a circular trajectory. This corresponds to the spacecraft having entered Mars's orbit. In the next video, we will compute the entire flight from Earth to Mars. Thank you very much and goodbye. Dankeschön und auf Wiedersehen.